Good afternoon and welcome to PME Vidya channel. I am with you Dharmendra Singh and you are watching this program under the Sahyog initiative. And today what we are going to learn that is learning how to learn. Of course, we are going to learn today and that is also has got a reason behind that and how we can start to learn. Obviously, so it can be start from the lower case, you can learn from step by step, then you can go to the higher level while learning, because learning is a very, very interesting outcomes and we need to learn. Obviously, that is the session all about for today. And to discuss more about this, we have got a couple of guests as well, couple of experts as well. I will introduce them one by one, but before I introduce them, I have got some information to give to our viewers. If you have any questions, any queries, you can get back to us on our toll free number, that is 1-800-112-65-1800-112-199. You can of course mail us as well on ciet.kishoremanch@gmail.com, that is our official email ID. Apart of this, you can, if you would like to catch us live, that is very easy. You need to go down to the YouTube and you can find us on NCRT YouTube channel. You can put your comment chat, you can put your questions over there as well, on a chat box and a comment box as well. Now it's time to introduce our expert. First, I would like to introduce Professor K. Chandrasekhar, RIE Ajmer. I welcome you, Mr. Chandrasekhar. And on the other hand, I would like to welcome Ms. Anjali Malik, practicing counselor. I welcome you, Ms. Malik.
Namaskar, sir.
All right. So now comes back to our topic, and my question is straight away to Professor K. Chandrasekhar, and what I would like to know, what is learning? That's a very simple question, and that is very important as well. If we can put some light on it, time is all yours now, Professor Chandrasekhar. Now you can start.
Good evening to all of you. Learning, how to learn is today's our topic. It is a very interesting topic and very, very important for all the students, even parents and all the stakeholders in the society. Learning basically, it is a process of acquiring skills, facts, figures, skills, values, even attitudes. That's how it is a layman's definition. That's how it can be told. And there are theories of learning, where we can say that theories of teaching, we have theories of learning, and some of the you might be knowing that cognitive theories and constructive theories, behavioristic theories. So there are theories, and it's a large area, and one whoever is interested, they can learn. And you can interestingly, there was an international commission on education for the 21st century, popularly known as Jacques Delors Commission, which was established, commissioned in 1996. And it was, in its report, there are four pillars of education. They are very popular worldwide, and about learning to know. See, here it is the learning, it is for knowing purpose, basically, acquiring knowledge, acquiring general knowledge, learning to know. And learning to do, it is acquiring skills and occupations, even competencies, that is another aspect. And learning to live together, it is again to develop one's own personality, to adjust with others, and to live harmoniously with others. And the fourth pillar is learning to be, it is also to develop an understanding of others, people, and appreciate of their interdependence. These are the popularly called the four pillars. You can see the importance. It is basically increasing the level. It is basically initially learning to know is acquiring facts, figures, skills, competencies, and learning to do, it is simply increasing acquired skills and occupations or competencies. So this is how it is increasing. And learning, it's not just memorization of facts, figures, or even theorems or principles, but also involves understanding. Basically, whatever we learn, we should learn with understanding. It's not just memorization, not just rote memorization. And further, it is making connections between previous and new knowledge. Previous knowledge means whenever we start learning, we connect to the whatever we know in our previous class or previous knowledge, and whatever we are learning, we will try to connect with the present knowledge, new knowledge, and using the knowledge in the new context. So this is how another way of telling learning. And we learn not only from teachers and books, but also from our observations and experience. Therefore, one way of learning doesn't work for everyone. Here, what I want to tell the viewers, we all might have heard about the joyful learning, discovery learning, activity-based learning. So it is not one way. It is if it is both a teacher and the students, if they involve in the activities, whatever they learn, so that will last forever. if it just memorizing the facts, memorizing the figures, memorizing the concepts, theorems or facts, then once the examination is over, evaluation is over, we tend to forget. So that's why, I mean, it's involving oneself. It is just what I can say, that constructing one's own knowledge. That is the, you know, as per constructivist approach, constructing knowledge by own students. That's what the present approach, constructivist approach. And here, learning how to learn. Here, learning how to learn helps students. You can see that understand how they can learn. Once the students know how they can learn, so they can understand how they can learn best. For example, if they know their strengths and weaknesses, so they know that what are their strengths, what are their weaknesses, and how they can learn their level best. And the other one is bridging the gap between current and future performance. Suppose if they know that, their weaknesses, so that they can build up, they can develop, so that they can perform well in the next coming, either it is examination or in their performance. And once if they know weaknesses and strengths, they can set realistic goals, so that if they set their goals too high, they may not be able to achieve. So they should set realistic goals and organize their learning material. So students nowadays have lots of material, supplementary material, textbooks, and even guidebooks. Through the internet, everything is in their hand itself. Through mobile, learning or Google or even lots of things. So though so much information, but exactly what exactly they need for their requirement, for their examinations, for their improving their conceptual understanding. So they should properly present, and accordingly they should manage time to achieve their goals. So once if they know all these things, strengths and weaknesses, so they can manage time according to their goals or examination or even competitive examinations.
Now I would like to stop here, Professor Chandrasekhar, if you can explain that thing as well, as you were explaining that there are lots of methods to understand how to learn. Right. But the question is that I'm talking about the teachers, how they are going to take this in the form of challenge as per the current scenario, everybody sitting at their home. How you people can make them easy to learn, although it is a very simple thing and a very common thing, but how we can start to make them learn. I'm talking about the student who basically would like to learn, but they don't know how to learn actually.
Yeah. Nowadays, see, it is a very interesting period and challenging periods nowadays. Since the last 6 months, it is very challenging for students, very challenging to teachers, even challenging to parents, everybody, all the stakeholders. And since it is mainly in the online teaching, online classes are happening in the school, in the colleges, everywhere. And there are lots of problems of, even from student side, they have been asked to sit for 3 periods, 5 periods, something like that. That means 3 to 4 hours, which is practically sitting before a laptop, before a computer for 4 hours, 5 hours is really not feasible. Practically it is very difficult, because students have the attention span around 30 to 35 minutes in a classroom situation. And when you ask to continuously sit for 4 hours, it's very, very strange, and it's happening. Mm-hmm. And students are not able to concentrate. Some of them, they are just switching on their online classroom, and they are they are offing their video, and they are doing some other things. This is also happening. So even the school administration or colleges, they should realize that they should take feedback, which exactly they are interested, what exactly they are interested. For example, some teachers, they are mechanically telling is also a problem, because now students are not able to tell the management, school management or school principal or headmistress, because they fear that if we share, they may harm us, internal marks or external marks somewhere. So they are not sharing actually, but they should, school management, the teachers, headmasters or principals, they should ask feedback from the students as well as from the parents, so that they will tell these are the problems, so that you can reduce the classes, or you can give a break in between the classes, something like. So, students can benefit, teachers also can benefit, even school administration get feedback. So this is how, I mean, in a better way to learn. And further, during this lockdown time, or I mean, this online classes, students should be asked to move, I mean, frequently share each other. At least they should know peer learning, learning from other students also. That is not happening online during the online classes. Hardly it is happening, because they are missing, I mean, badly, that in the school situation, traditional classroom situation, they go and mix and share whatever is happening inside the classroom. And whatever some students are weak, they are coming to, I mean, they will be able to know from other students. They are getting what is happening in the school. I am not able to understand the concept. I am not able to understand this principle or theorem. So they, if they share, that is how peer learning is happening. That is one of the best way of getting conceptual clarity. Yes.
Right. Great. You have mentioned, you know, a certain point behind that, because you have mentioned a couple of things, like some smart students and there are some weak students as well, how you are going to make adjustment so they can learn in a holistic way. Now, recently we have heard about NEP, and that is National Education Policy. So I would like from you to, you know, elaborate, Professor Chandrasekhar, if you can, what are the guiding principle about this NEP, that is National Education Policy, if you can understand this.
Yeah. Here the guiding principle of our national education policy is one of the guiding principle is, I mean, students, whatever they learn, it's not just learning by rote memorization. Rote memorization, what happens, they can pass the examination, they can get good divisions, first division, second division, something like, or maybe distinction or topper. But once their examinations is over, I mean, when they get promoted to next class, higher class, they are tend to forget whatever they learned. But if they learn with understanding, whatever concepts they learned, whatever theorems, principles, or anything whatever they learned, if they understand with clarity, conceptual clarity, they will never forget. So that's how one of the basic principle, I mean, guiding principle in national education policy is, students should understand whatever they are learning. So it is something like that, no, whatever they learned in the present classroom or the present situation, they should use that knowledge, that skill, that competency in real life situation, so that whatever their knowledge they learn, that they should use as, you know, they should apply that knowledge, right? The other focus of NEP is on desired learning outcomes. So learning outcomes, what they are actually, whatever, you know, in the whole year, what the students, you know, they are learning from the that subject, respective subjects. For example, it is basically, suppose somebody is, I mean, in mathematics, whatever chapters, units or topics are there, and what students are supposed to learn before they complete that. For example, class 9th students, whatever he is supposed to learn in the class 9 mathematics subject, after learning that, if he is getting promoted to class 10th, these are the learning outcomes where we can test through. There are the tests like a national achievement surveys, and even there internationally, there are PISA program for international student assessment. It's called popularly known as PISA test, conducted by OECD, Organization for Economic Cooperation Development. And there the test is being conducted in 76 countries. But in our country, National Achievement Survey, on behalf of MHRD, NCRD is conducting, the National Achievement Surveys in different stages, class 3, class 5, class 7, 8, class 10. There, they test the learning outcomes through National Achievement Survey, so that what students know, what students can do, that can be assessed, and that feedback can be given to teachers, students, parents, even the administrators, policymakers, even politicians, so that they will come to know that broadly in our country, what all class 9 students in different subjects know and then can do in mathematics, science, social science, English, Hindi, like that. So here, learning outcomes are very important. Otherwise, without ensuring learning outcomes, if students keep on getting promoted, so that, it is something like a non-detention system or no detention system. Without ensuring, what knowledge, what skills, what competences they have learned, and if you keep on promoting, and when they go for that board examinations or university examination, competitive examinations, or for employment, they will miserably fail. So this is what, why this is, that is why that focus on conceptual understanding and learning outcomes. I mean, this is the main focus in national education policy.
Definitely, and. Whatever you have explained, that is directly connected to the self-esteem, and if they can follow all these things, they will definitely, grow in their future. That is what exactly have been explained by the Professor K. Chandrasekhar. Now it's time to move to our another expert. She is waiting for so long. Ms. Anjali Malik, if you can hear me.
Yes, sir.
Right. आपकी आवाज थोड़ा सा स्लो आ रही है, प्लीज ट्राई टू मेक इट ओके. द प्रश्न ये है, द क्वेश्चन इज दैट कि अभी तक हमने ये समझा कि लर्निंग को हम किस तरीके से लर्न करें, वो भी एक कला है. अब हम ये समझना चाहते हैं कि क्या हमारे लिए इसकी कोई एक स्ट्रेटेजी होती है, एक रणनीति होती है जिसके तहत हम इसको समझने की कोशिश करें. तो अगर आप लर्निंग की जो स्ट्रेटेजीज हैं उसको थोड़ा सा अगर आप हमें समझा पाएं फिर हम इसे स्टार्ट करें.
जी, सो आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट लर्निंग स्ट्रेटेजीज. फर्स्ट इज से नो टू प्रोक्रेस्टिनेशन. प्रोक्रेस्टिनेशन होता है जो हम चीजों को कल पे टालते हैं. सो व्हाट यू कैन डू इज ब्रेक द टास्क इनटू स्मॉलर पार्ट्स सो दैट इट इज इजियर टू डू, एंड ऑल्सो मिनिमाइज योर डिस्ट्रैक्शंस लाइक कीपिंग योर फोन अवे फ्रॉम योर सेल्फ और स्विचिंग इट ऑफ. देन यू कैन यूज पोमोडोरो टेक्निक. दे यू स्टडी फॉर 25 मिनट्स एंड देन टेक अ 5 मिनट ब्रेक, एंड ड्यूरिंग दोज 5 मिनट्स यू कैन डू समथिंग यू लाइक. For example, you can doodle or draw, color, or even dance. Picture walk, that is scanning the chapter, going through the chapter and noticing the major points like headings, diagrams, summary and questions so that you know what is coming. Then you can also use mind mapping. It is a diagrammatic representation of the key ideas. You write the head in the middle of the page and the sub-themes and subheads around it. Also, you need to space your learning. Not trying to learn a lot of material in a day, like just before your exam, and divide the material and then work through it. You can also use mnemonics. You can like remembering the location of where the material was written, or you can also use acronyms like random access memory is called RAM. Then you can also make a story with your learning material. Then there is active recall. You have to turn off, you have to look away from the book and then see what you can recall. जो क्या आपको याद रहता है book बंद करने के बाद. And finally reflecting on your performance. Reflecting what did you understand and which are the areas which can be improved.
Right. एक चीज़ हम यहाँ पर ये भी देखें कि विभिन्न तरीके की हम प्रोसेस की बात करते हैं कि लर्निंग आउटकम्स हैं या फिर किसी भी विषय से संबंधित किसी भी चीज़ को अगर हम फॉलो कर रहे हैं, एक रणनीति है. यस, बिल्कुल स्ट्रेटेजी हमें बनानी चाहिए. दूसरी तरफ हम बात करते हैं कि एक एक प्रक्रिया होती है, प्रोसेस होती है. सपोज करिए कि हम लर्निंग आउटकम्स के एक प्रोसेस के तहत आगे बढ़ रहे हैं, उन प्रोसेस को, उन प्रक्रियाओं को कितना और तरीके से बेहतर किया जा सकता है लर्निंग आउटकम्स के मद्देनज़र.
जी, सो लर्निंग प्रोसेस में तीन एक साइकिल होती है जिसमें प्लानिंग, मॉनिटरिंग एंड इवेल्युएशन आता है, एंड देन देयर इज रिफ्लेक्शन व्हिच इज एट द हार्ट ऑफ दिस साइकिल. प्लानिंग में हम अपना गोल सेट करते हैं, अपना लर्निंग गोल सेट करते हैं, एंड देन स्टेप्स डिसाइड करते हैं उसको रीच करने के लिए. मॉनिटरिंग में हम वो स्टेप्स को इम्प्लीमेंट करते हैं एंड देखते हैं कि हम कितना प्रोग्रेस कर रहे हैं, क्या हम अपने गोल की तरफ जा रहे हैं, हमारा डायरेक्शन सही है या नहीं. एंड इवेल्युएशन में जब हम फाइनली परफॉर्मेंस देते हैं तब हम देखते हैं कि क्या हमारी प्लानिंग और मॉनिटरिंग सही थी, क्या हमारा रिजल्ट हमारे गोल से मैच करता है. एंड रिफ्लेक्शन हर एक स्टेप पे होता है. इवन प्लानिंग के फेज में हमको देखना होता है कि क्या हमारा पोटेंशियल मैच कर रहा है जो भी हमने गोल सेट किए हैं. और रिफ्लेक्शन के थ्रू ही हमें पता चलता है कि हमारे लिए कौन सी बेस्ट स्ट्रैटेजी है, क्योंकि हम डिफरेंट स्ट्रैटेजीज पे लगा के देख सकते हैं. ये जो लर्निंग प्रोसेस है ये सिर्फ स्टूडेंट्स के लिए नहीं है, ये वर्किंग प्रोफेशनल्स के लिए भी है एंड किसी भी पर्सन के लिए है जो कि कुछ भी सीखना चाहते हैं. बिकॉज ये हमारी एक माइंड की हैबिट डेवलप करते हैं टुवर्ड्स लर्निंग विच इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर लर्निंग. सो नोइंग दिस प्रोसेस ऑफ प्लानिंग, मॉनिटरिंग, इवेल्युएशन एंड रिफ्लेक्शन विल हेल्प अस अंडरस्टैंड द बेस्ट वे वी लर्न एज वेल एज व्हाट वर्क्स बेस्ट फॉर अस.
आप सुन पा रहे हैं मेरी आवाज़ आ रही है अब तक?
जी.
राइट, आपने प्रोसेस भी हमें बताया, आपने हमें रणनीति के बारे में भी बताया. एक सामान्य सा प्रश्न है जो कि बहुत प्रैक्टिकल है और मैं समझता हूँ कि थोड़ा सा इसको भी आप क्लियर करें तो बहुत बेहतर. खासतौर से अभी 6-7 महीने की जो यात्रा रही है बहुत दुखदाई, उस चीज़ को दोबारा से नहीं बोलना चाहूँगा, लेकिन यस उस कारण की वजह से अगर हम घर में हैं तो कितना बड़ा एक चैलेंज निकल कर आया है टीचर के लिए भी, स्टूडेंट्स के लिए भी, जो अपनी बात पहुँचाना चाह रहे हैं लेकिन पहुँच नहीं रही, और जिन तक पहुँचनी चाहिए वो बात वहाँ तक करने की कोई सोच नहीं रहा है। लेकिन यस देर सवेर कहीं ना कहीं इसके बारे में सोचा गया और अब हम अपनी बात कहीं ना कहीं डिजिटल मीडिया के माध्यम से अपने बच्चों तक पहुँचा पा रहे हैं। तो कितना बड़ा एक चैलेंज आपके लिए रहा और इसमें और भी क्या बेहतर सुझाव आप करना चाहेंगे कि और बेहतर तरीके से हम अपनी बातों को स्टूडेंट्स तक पहुंचा सकें?
आई थिंक एनसीईआरटी ने एक बहुत ही अच्छी चीज स्टार्ट की है डिजिटल मीडियम पे, सो आई थिंक व्हिच इज वेरी नाइस, व्हिच इज अ गुड वर्क, एंड हम ऐसे ही डिजिटल मीडियम से बच्चों से जुड़ सकते हैं एंड और एक रूटीन बना सकते हैं, एक बेटर रूटीन बना सकते हैं।
जो बेटर रूटीन की आप बात कर रही हैं वो किस पे में लेकर जाए? रूटीन तो खैर हम अपने खेलने का ही बना सकते हैं, हम यहाँ पर पढ़ाई लिखाई की बात करें। यस रूटीन की आपने बात करी, मैं आपसे ये जानना चाहता हूँ कि चलिए हमने रूटीन बना लिया, अक्सर एक जो ह्यूमन टेंडेंसी होती है, अभी भी हमारे पास 2 मिनट का वक्त है इसलिए मैं आपसे जानना चाह रहा हूँ कि रूटीन चलिए हमने बनाया लेकिन हम उसको फॉलो नहीं करते कहीं ना कहीं, सारे स्टूडेंट्स को, मैं अपने आप को भी उसमें कोट करके देख रहा हूँ, तो हमको इस आदत को किस तरीके से सुधारना चाहिए और आदत को किस तरीके से आदत में भी डाल लेना चाहिए, इसको हम किस तरीके से समझें?
हमारा जो ब्रेन है वो रिवॉर्ड बेस्ड लर्निंग पे डिपेंड करता है, तो हम अगर कोई भी हैबिट डेवलप करना चाहते हैं तो एक चीज हमें याद रखनी होती है कि जब भी हम वो चीज करें, जो भी हम जिसकी हैबिट डेवलप करना चाहते हैं, उसके बाद हम कोई एक अपने लिए एक अच्छी चीज करें जो कि हमारे लिए एक रिवॉर्ड का काम करेगी। फॉर एग्जाम्पल अगर आप एक चैप्टर पूरा पढ़ लेते हैं तो फिर आप जो भी आपको पसंद है, अगर आपको ड्रॉइंग करना पसंद है, पेंटिंग करना पसंद है या मूवीज देखना पसंद है, तो आप कोई भी एक चीज ऐसे कर सकते हैं एंड धीरे धीरे वो हैबिट में टर्न हो जाएगी, अगर और फिर हमको वो रिवॉर्ड की जरूरत भी नहीं पड़ेगी।
चलिए कितने आसान शब्दों में और बहुत कम वक्त में आपने इस नायाब सी बात को बताया, गागर में सागर भरना, इसी को कहते हैं कम बोलना लेकिन बहुत ज़्यादा समझना। यस आप रूटीन कैसे बनाएंगे उसको आदत में आपको शुमार करना पड़ेगा, छोटे छोटे गोल बनाकर चलने में भी समझदारी है, बड़े गोल की अगर हम तरफ जाएंगे तो बहुत बोझिल सा हो जाता है। ये कुछ एक चीज़ें थी जो इस सहयोग कार्यक्रम के अंतर्गत हमने समझी और मैं आशा करता हूँ कि आपको ये प्रोग्राम बहुत अच्छा लगा होगा, समझ में आया होगा और जो भी सुझाव आपको दिए गए हैं आप उनको अमल में लाएंगे, उनको फॉलो करेंगे। बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया दोनों ही एक्सपर्ट्स, प्रोफेसर के चंद्रशेखर हमसे आपका जुड़ने का बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया सर, थैंक यू सो मच फॉर बीइंग विद अस। राइट, थैंक यू सो मच मिस अंजलि मलिक, आपका भी बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया हमसे जुड़ने के लिए।
थैंक यू सर,
और बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया आप सभी का भी जितने लोग हमें देख रहे थे, सुन रहे थे। फिलहाल ये समय तो हो गया समाप्त लेकिन ज्ञान की जो यात्रा है वो मुसलसल जारी है, आप बने रहिए पीएम ई विद्या चैनल पर और देते रहिए अपने सुझाव, घर में रहिए, अपना खास ख्याल रखिए, बाहर अकारण बिल्कुल भी मत जाइए, मास्क और सैनिटाइजर का प्रयोग तो हर हाल में कीजिए। फिलहाल मुझे दीजिए इजाज़त, नमस्कार।
नमस्कार सर, थैंक यू।